We could do with a glass of the amber fluid, couldn't we, mate?
That's for sure.
What about it?
Only got bottles.
What are you waiting for, love? You on your own?
No.
What's the damage?
43 cents.
Right, now, where's the boss?
In there.
Okay. Come on.
You're sacked. You heard me. Pack your things and go. I won't have sly grog in my place.
Are you saying I didn't know?
My oath I am.
Mind if I look round?
Help yourself. Nice little sideline you had going, wasn't it?
What's your name, miss?
Faye Parker.
I have to ask you to accompany me to the station.
Me? But he...
You can explain all that later.
I'm gonna wash my hands and get me back.
All right.
Try and help these kids.
You want the cuffs on, do you?
Can't stay with me, Aunt Honest. She's driving me mad.
Yeah, but do you know anybody in Melbourne?
Not really. But you'll be going back, won't you, when the dam's finished?
Yeah, well,
You don't want me there.
Well, it's just that the dam won't be finished for a couple of months.
You don't care, do you? Oh,
look, I do.
You don't.
You just reckon everything's so easy, Faye.
Anyway, it's Georgie and Daphne. They'll be in Melbourne.
Oh, you don't want to mix with them, do you?
Why not? They're nice.
Give it up, Faye.
I don't care what they do. They're nice and I like them.
You want to end up like them, do you?
What is it to you?
And a filthy old caravan with a pimp bludgeon on you.
I don't care. It's better than staying here.
I should have known better. I've spoilt you. I've been too soft. Your mother over there'd turn in her grave if she knew. And not an apology. Not even as much as I'm sorry. Well, you're not going back to that place again. I'm not going to take my eyes off you.
But my bike's still there.
Somebody else can collect it.
And Mr. Johnson still owes me wages for last week. He said I could get it tonight. If I don't pick it up, he might think I don't want it.
All right. But you come straight back, do you hear?
Hello. Hello, sweetie, how'd you go?
How was it?
All right. Where's Alec? Oh, he's off gallivanting in Matlock. What's wrong?
It's me money.
Hasn't he paid you? Like I'll end up a fiver?
No, I'll come back tomorrow. Can I leave a note?
Sure.
Not for him, for Tommy.
Tommy?
The young bloke in room two.
Gone on him, are you? Come on.
She's blushing.
It's like him, that's all.
Come on. You write it all down. I'll see he gets it.
How long have you known him?
A fortnight.
I should never have taken you in. I should have left you in that home. I'd know how to deal with someone like you.
I done nothing wrong.
I saw you.
We was kissing, that's all. What's wrong with that?
You hardly know him.
I wanted to kiss him the first time I saw him.
Will you be quiet?
How would you understand? You only love people who are dead, and you're deader than all of them.
Faye, I want to talk to you.
What about?
Your future. What on earth have you got on?
Not now, Aunt Gertrude.
Sit down. Your young man can wait a few minutes.
It's not just him.
Who else?
Friends.
Do I know them? Or don't you think I should? Why don't you bring them here? Are you ashamed of me?
Hey, what's the matter?
Come on, you're all right now. Come on, I'll take you to a doctor, then home.
I can't. She won't help me back.
Well, come on, I'll take you to the car. That's it.
Thanks, Cheryl, and tell Sergeant Madden Gary's just arrived.
Righto, Steve.
I reckon I ought to get her to hospital.
Come on, we've got to get going while there's still a chance we get to Matlock. I'll come with you.
What?
Well, I've got to show you where he is.
Where who is?
My father. My father's trapped in the river. You've got to help me, please.
please. Well, he'll drown. The water's rising. His leg's caught under the water. Couldn't free him by myself.
Walk in front of me.
Look, I'm going that way. I'll send someone back to help your old man, okay?
But you'll drown. Is there a phone?
No. It's only a weekender. Somewhere to get away from it all.
Mum and Dad will be worried about me.
You'll be safe here until someone finds you.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to get some sleep. Get away in the morning. Good morning. Sleep well?
Did you put this on me?
You got a bit chilly last night.
Thank you.
So how do you feel this morning?
A bit better. What time is it?
The time I was moving on.
Oh.
No way I... I'll be sorry to go.
You have to go?
Afraid so.
Why?
You know, I've been in jail.
I guessed.
Well, I got away.
You're not really free, though, are you?
I could have been.
Only for a while. I mean, even if you hadn't stopped to help me, you'd have been caught sooner or later.
Well, maybe, maybe not. I had a lot going for me. Anyway, I might still make it. What's your name?
Christine Evans. Chris. What's yours?
What's it matter? If I told you, you'd only have to forget it.
Well, I won't tell anyone about us, I promise. After all, you saved my life.
Yeah, but I killed someone else.
Hypodermic? Oh, Teresa, that's mainlining. Well, I didn't want to go that far. You can get really hooked on that stuff.
Don't you believe it? They only say that to put us off. Well, they want us to have a good time.
Now, show me your arm.
But, Teresa, I'm not sure. You read so many awful things.
They only say that. This way it goes straight into the bloodstream. The effect is instantaneous. It's wild. You'll be way up there.
But it's dangerous. People have died from taking it.
Sure. But anything can kill you if you overdo it. I mean, what about drink and smokes?
Kid, wake up to yourself. Get with it. The oldies have their drugs. Why can't we have ours? Okay?
Now, clench your fist and unclench your fist and work your arm up and down.
Like this, you mean?
Yeah, that's right.
Why do I do this?
To bring the vein up, dummy. Mm. Now, just do it a bit more. Good. That's cool.
Now, are you ready?
Yes. All right. I'm ready.
Here we go. This will really send you wild. I promise.
Do you feel up to answering a few questions now, Miss Perry?
I don't know if there's anything I can tell you.
It's like I said, Mr. Redford. Doug didn't have an enemy in the world.
Had at least three, Mr. Perry. Yeah. Did he ever have arguments in here with bikies?
No. Got on well with all of them, didn't he, love?
That's right. And Doug's that kind of person.
Now, you're both sure there were no arguments, not even small ones like giving wrong change or giving standard petrol instead of super, that sort of thing?
There were no arguments, Mr. Redford. Doug was a great bloke.
Okay, well, look, I'll probably be back, but that'll be all for now. And thanks for your cooperation. Okay.
I don't know what to say, love.
Oh, it's incredible. I don't know how news like this is going to affect Miss Mason.
Poor old son, she's muffing the plate without this.
It was good of you to come over, Gail. I could do with your help. Ruth, look who's here.
Miss Mason, I came to see if there's anything I can do. It's Gail Perry.
She didn't believe Doug was dead until I'd come back from identifying him.
Shouldn't we call a doctor or something?
Any success with the bikie groups, Mark?
No. No, it's a mistake sending uniformed men out, sir. Bikies won't talk to them.
Any suggestions?
Well, you need someone that can talk bikes and racing in their own language.
You sold your bike, didn't you, Mark?
Yeah, but I can borrow one.
All right, you've got the job.
The doctor says she'll sleep for several hours with that shot he gave her.
It'll do her good. I thought you might like a cuppa.
Thanks. Look, Gail, you said you wanted to help in some way, right?
Well, of course, anything I can do.
Well, there is. I have to go out. I must. I was just wondering if you could stay in case Ruth wakes up and wants anything.
Do you feel up to going out?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm fine. I appreciate this, Gail. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Three burgers, thanks, son.
Plain?
Plain. Sorry to hear about Doug.
Thank you. Did you know him?
Yeah, he served as a petrol a couple of times. Nice guy. Why do you want to kill a nice guy like Doug?
Police will find out.
Oh, I wouldn't count too much in the Fazler.
Why do you say that?
Well, they're not too bright, you know. Sometimes you can do a favour for them and they wouldn't know it. You, Doug's chick, eh?
Yes. Now, look, if you don't mind, I'd like to forget the...
What do you know about him?
What?
What do you know about his sideline?
What sideline? Now, will you stop asking me all these questions?
Don't know anything, Con. Yeah, OK. I must have the wrong guy. Hang up with the burgers. I'm getting hungry.
Hey, you know what? I just lost my appetite.
Me too.
And what about you?
No, I ain't hungry either.
Oh, sorry, love. Looks like you've got three burgers left in your hands.
Very smart. Hey, Dad!
Oh, she's gonna call Daddy.
Why don't we just pay up and split? It's obvious she don't know nothing.
No, she's just acting dumb.
Come on. She wouldn't have a clue.
Now, what's this about not paying for the burgers you ordered?
I'm just not hungry anymore, Chief.
You ordered them, you paid for them.
I came for the lunchtime trade, Chief. We're gonna split.
Now look, collect your burgers and pay up.
I'm busted. You got anything?
Just this.
Dad?
Well, looks like it might be enough. What do you reckon, Chief?
Look, you can't come bursting in here throwing your weight around.
Well, what are you complaining about? I mean, you still got the burgers, haven't you?
Let's see. Let's go.
He was in a couple of hours ago with two of his mates. Gave Gail a bit of a hard time.
They ordered burgers and said they didn't want them.
And I poked my nose in. One of them came out with his bike chain, now to a bit of broomstick.
Threaten you with it?
Not in so many words, no.
Have you ever seen them before?
Well, they're not regulars, but they have been here, with the one in the picture.
They were on about Doug, too.
Oh?
Well, it's rather hard to explain.
Well, maybe you better tell me exactly what happened.
Hello. Steve. Oh, Steve, how are you?
Can you talk? I must see you, Sue.
Not here. Can I meet you somewhere?
I don't know where, Sue. I'm in trouble. I have to see you.
Where are you?
Who are you talking to?
A girlfriend, Dad.
Look, what say I meet you in half an hour?
I'm near a park. I don't know where
There must be a street name somewhere.
Now, you listen to me, young man. You call my daughter again, I'll notify the police.
Sue? Sue!
She's your daughter, too. Why is it always up to me to put my foot down?
What do you expect me to do? She's a bit old to lock in her room.
Well, talk to her, for God's sake. That young idiot won't take no from us. Perhaps you'll believe it coming from her.
I can't force her. If you were any sort of a man, you'd...
Now, where do you think you're going?
Insist on talking about me in the third person, then do it when I'm not here.
We're going to settle this once and for all.
I love him, Dad. Maybe you can stop me seeing him, but you can't stop me loving him.
You don't know what love is. You're too young.
Well, I'm old enough to leave home. Sue.
You're old enough when I say so.
You say so? Steve was good enough for me until a few days ago, until you thought he came from a bad home. Well, what's so good about this home?
That's your boyfriend.
Sue, he doesn't mean all those things. He doesn't want to see you hurt. Neither of us do. We only want what's best for you.
Really? Were you just worried about what people will think?
Detective Sergeant Hills, Detective Dawson. My daughter Sue and my wife.
Yeah? Could I talk to your daughter alone, Mr. Golly?
Well, I didn't really think...
What's happened?
I'd like to have a word with your daughter, Mrs. Golly.
Steve, isn't it? He's in trouble.
His mother's concerned about him, that's all.
Any idea where he might be, Miss Golding?
No, I haven't seen him for days.
He hasn't tried to contact you?
We don't see each other anymore, not since...
You broke up your engagement. Because of Steve's father's background, is that it?
There are a number of reasons.
Religion?
No.
I see. All right, Miss Golding, thanks for your help.
If he does try to contact you, would you let us know, please?
In the cellar.
This is ridiculous.
Get in.
Sue, let's get out of here and get married in Sydney.
Steve, it won't work. You've only made things worse.
If it's your parents you're worried about, they can't stop us. They can't hurt us.
Can't you get it through your head? You can't push people around like this. They're still my parents.
I can't stand around here waiting for your parents to make up their mind. Either you come with me now or I'll... You've got to come with me now, Sue.
Oh, you're what, Steve? What have you done? Look, if you're in trouble, let me help. Steve, please.
Leave me alone! Or someone's gonna get hurt.
Sue?
Shut up!
All right. What's going on out there?
I'm okay, Dad! Hear anything?
Nothing. It's all quiet.
Maybe he's gone. Try the door.
Leave it a while longer.
We can't stay down here forever. Do something.
Well, what do you expect me to do? Break the door down, get myself killed?
Probably kill us all anyway. Oh, for goodness sake, Mummy won't hurt us. Oh, no? He shoots at the police, doesn't he? What makes you think he'll stop there? If you weren't have interfered in the first place, none of this would have happened.
Don't you speak to your mother like that. I warned you about him, but you wouldn't listen. Oh, no. He loves you.
Sue, come up here.
Don't.
If you hurt my daughter, I'll kill you. I swear it.
Sue, I'm leaving. And I want you to come with me.
Oh, how far do you think we'll get, Steve? The police are after you. They're not going to let you go just like that.
They will if they see you, too.
You're in trouble. It's better you face them. I'll be with you. I promise.
Steve! Steve Berry, it's Bluey Hills. Steve, your mother's here. She wants to talk to you. I'm not armed. There's nothing to be afraid of.
Please, Steve, let me talk to you.
It won't do any harm, Steve.
All right. Come around the front door.
You better go downstairs. I don't want you to get hurt.
It's the only way.
But that's impossible.
Nothing's impossible. Not when I've got this.
I'm sick of being cheated, lied to. Do this, do that. It's me now. I'm the one telling them what to do. For once, they're listening to me.
You're frightening me, Steve.
It'll work out, Sue. I'll make it work.
Well, we could hardly send in a real priest, could we? If something goes wrong, you might get shot.
Exactly. If you give up, Steve, we can get married properly.
No chance. If I chuck it in now, I'll never see you again. Your parents will make sure of that.
I won't let them stop me. Not anymore.
You wouldn't have a chance, and you know it.
If you loved me, you wouldn't be doing this.
There's no way I'm even going to try to live without you, Sue. You better get back down the cellar. Tell your parents.
What's happening?
Are you all right, love?
I'm okay, dear. What are the police doing? They've got to get us out of here.
Oh, it'll be all right, love. You'll see.
I realize the ceremony will be rather unorthodox, but you have nothing to fear.
In the lounge.
I don't suppose you'd consider putting down your gun during the ceremony. Well, if we could have the bride here and the bridegroom there and the bride's father on the right...
I'd like Mr. and Mrs. Golding behind you, where I can see them.
It's a bit irregular.
So's this. Okay.
In name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost, amen. Dear friends, we gathered in this place so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister in this community. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness confirm your consent and fill you both with his blessing. What God has joined, men must not divide. Amen. Put the ring on the Bible.
I haven't got one.
Well, under these circumstances...
Hold it right there, cop. You should learn how to cross yourself properly, you bastards!
But Pete, no!
Run, get out of here!
Sue!
Where are you heading?
Jindara. I've got to find the vet in a hurry.
Oh, no, just a bloke.
Point of fact, bit of an emergency.
Hello, it's Melissa. She's having trouble.
Sorry, Jack. Excuse me.
Oh, yes.
Is she all right?
Yeah, well, I'll just see if I can find another leg in there.
Unless she's only got one leg. It's got two.
Two.
There it is. There
what about
it is.
Four?
Well, it's got two front ones anyway. They're the ones we've got to get out. Here we go. There we are. That's oh. better.
Good
that's
girl.
That's better, Melissa.
Good girl.
Look at her. She's proud of herself now. She's doing it all herself. A few more squeezes, girl. Here we come. There we are.
Good girl.
Here we come. Good girl. Come on, girl. No wonder she got tired.
That's wonderful. You're clever. Well, isn't Melissa a clever little thing? Twins.
Just make sure they're both getting plenty of milk, otherwise one of them might have to go on a supplementary diet.
Oh, I'm sure she'll handle all that beautifully. She's a real smarty. Though I don't know what we'd have done without you. Perhaps lost one of them. Or both, even.
Oh, no, I wouldn't say that.
Oh, no, no. Until you came along, Melissa wasn't doing it all well. You're wonderful. Just wonderful.
Oh, well, just part of the job, you know.
I often wish I had the brains to become a vet. Come in so handy these days. Years and years of learning.
Oh, yeah.
Must have been worth it, though, I bet.
Well, times like these it is.
Yeah. There's just one small problem.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm terribly sorry about this, really I am, but, well, you're obviously such an understanding and compassionate person. We're stony broke. We can't pay you, not a cent. Must be awful out there, slogging along behind Jock.
Peter's here, everybody. I'm going to make him a cuppa.
G'day.
G'day.
I'm Tess.
I'm Peter.
Sorry, I can't offer you one of these. They're rationed. Workers only.
Thanks, Tess.
Is there anything else I can get you, Ray?
No, not at the moment.
How's the cough?
Cough?
Oh, you should have heard him this morning. I thought he had one foot in the grave.
It's a bit better.
Oh, well, that settles it. If it starts raining again, you're not going back out there.
Oh, Georgie.
Now, you listen to me, Ray Turner. We're very grateful for what you're doing for us, but there's no sense killing yourself. Well, there'll be other days when you can do the ploughing.
Of course, on the other hand, some really solid exercise might do him the world of good. You know, sweat out the infection, often recommended for horses.
Ray's not a horse. You're doing a very good job, Ray.
Just one furrow?
Well, you should try working with that overgrown lump of horse flesh and the original stump jump plough.
That's what I mean. You know, you're doing it all wrong. Well, I mean, nobody uses a horse and plough anymore, do they? You know, it's all mechanized. Unless that's against your philosophy.
Come to think of it, there's an old tractor out in the shed. Doesn't seem to work, though.
Well, maybe Ray could fix it. It'd keep me out of the rain, wouldn't it?
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Sorry to take so long with your tea, sir. Practically had to milk the cow.
A pity you've got a dash after you finish that, Peter. Otherwise, you could have helped us with the tractor.
April and I'll do the washing up, won't we, April? I'd like to see somebody try and stop us. What are you boys doing this afternoon?
First things first, let's get rid of the washing up. Come on, April.
Georgie, sometimes I wonder about you.
Hey, there's water pouring into the kitchen.
I mean, there's no reason to jump to the obvious conclusion. You know, I mean, Ray could have got across that river okay.
Sure, it'll just take him long to get to town without Jock.
Yeah, you know, he'll use his head, though. He'll get to the nearest farm or he'll hitch a ride.
Of course.
He could be lying out there hurt or swept away.
George,
some
don't.
I think we have to look at it like this. We can't expect help for quite a while yet, so all we can do is do the best we can for Tess.
Peter!
Coming! Oh, I wouldn't mention any of this to Tess at the moment, you know? She's under enough strain as it is. Okay, Georgie?
I've got to know what's happened to Ray.
Georgie!
Look, I won't be much use here anyway. I've got to try and find him.
You just be careful out there, understand?
Ray! Ray!
Well, we're set for food. Not sure about clothes, though.
Oh, you've got a whole bag full there.
You look thinner than I am. Not sure they'll fit you.
Yeah, I'll manage.
Just hope we're doing the right thing.
Can't speak for you, Jan, but I know I am. I'm doing the only thing I can do if I want to stay alive.
Miss Mackenzie must be frantic not knowing where you are.
That's the whole point, don't you see? As long as nobody knows where I am, I'm safe. And that includes Miss Mackenzie and Bruce Russell. If they don't believe Rita Merrick's after me to kill me, they don't believe anything I tell them. They think I'm crazy. You don't think I'm crazy, do you, Jan?
I wouldn't be here if I did.
You'll never know how grateful I am to you for believing in me. You're the only one.
When your memory comes back, they'll believe you. All of them.
I wonder.
They'll have to. Well, only you know who killed Richard. Only you know the truth.
If I could just remember what I saw when I came out of that room.
You will. Before too long, you'll remember. I know you will.
You know, you're so totally different to what I imagined you'd be.
From Richard's description of me?
From some of the things he said, I pictured you as being evil, quite without morals or feelings of any kind.
I can believe that.
Is it possible someone could distort the truth so much?
Oh, yes, Richard could. The worst part was he believed it in his own mind. He was so eaten up by jealousy and mistrust that he was incapable of seeing anything but bad in people, especially me. I thought when we had the baby, things might change. They only got 100 times worse.
A baby? You and Richard had a baby?
Yeah, a boy.
Well, what happened to him?
Nothing, thank God. He's growing into quite a little man.
Well, where is he now? Well, why aren't you with him?
Well, at present he's with my parents, but I'm hoping to be in a position to take care of him myself very soon.
I had no idea. Richard never mentioned anything about having a baby.
Doesn't surprise me either. He refused to accept it as his.
He refused to accept it?
He was convinced it was the offspring of one of my countless lovers. The irony of it was, there was never anyone else. Never in all the time I knew Richard did I so much as look at another man twice.
The dispute will be resolved before next Tuesday, when the strikers will meet to discuss the issue further.
You sure you're all right? You look absolutely dreadful.
Oh, it's nothing. I've just got a bit of a headache, that's all.
Watching television won't help it. Look, why don't you lie down, or better still, go to bed?
Yeah, I think I will. Hey, look, it's me.
Anyone with information that may assist the police in their search is urged to contact the CIB at this number without delay. The police are also anxious to trace Miss Rita Merrick for questioning in connection with the murder of schoolteacher Richard Dawson, who was stabbed to death in his flat on Monday morning last. Any person knowing the whereabouts of Miss Merrick is a...
You said they didn't believe you when you told them she was still in town.
Well, they didn't.
Well, they must now. Otherwise, why would they put that message over?
I don't know. All I know is that she's out there somewhere waiting for a chance to kill.
How would you like working in the advertising business?
Well, it's different. I mean, it's sort of more exciting than most jobs.
Penny seems to like it.
Yes.
Forgive me for saying so. You don't seem the type I'd expect Warren Stafford's secretary to be.
You know Mr. Stafford?
I'm the company doctor.
Oh, of course, Penny mentioned you were. No, I don't suppose I am very suitable for the job, but I'm trying hard to be.
Sure, you'd try hard at anything you did. I think you'd probably succeed.
Hello.
Another nightmare?
It was the same one, only this time I saw it happen.
Saw the murder happen?
Yeah, I came out of the room. I couldn't see who did it. The figures were so blurred, I couldn't even tell if it was a man or a woman.
At least it proved something. If you saw someone else kill Richard, it couldn't have been you.
No, that's right. No, it couldn't have been.
You say you couldn't be sure if it was a man or a woman?
No, I couldn't see her very clearly.
Her? Then it was a woman.
This is all making sense. There's only one person it could have been. Only one.
Who?
Rita Merrick. Who else?
I wish you'd eat something. I'm sure you'd feel much better.
I've just got no appetite. I wish I'd get rid of this wretched headache.
As soon as I finish my coffee, I'll go down and get you some tablets.
No, please, I don't want to be left alone.
Well, it'll only take a minute. I can probably get some from the desk, and if not, there's a chemist just down the street.
Look, I know I'm being foolish. I can't help it, but I'd go out of my mind if I was left here by myself, even for a minute.
Well, we'll both go then.
After that picture of me on the television, I daren't put my nose outside the door. Someone's bound to recognize me. Please, just stay with me.
Very well. No better?
No. Just keeps getting worse. It feels like there's a sledgehammer in there.
I'm not going to let you go on suffering like this. I'm going down to get some tablets right now, and I don't want any argument.
Okay, please hurry.
Yes, I will. I'll be back as quick as I possibly can.
Thank goodness you're back. Rita, how did you get in here?
It wasn't so difficult to obtain a pass key. Then it was simply a matter of waiting till your friend left you here alone.
Well, she's only gone down the street. She'll be back in a moment.
Not before I've done what I came to do.
No!
You killed Richard.
Oh, you'll never tell anyone anything.
No.
Again, Alison. Yes. Oh. It was you. You did it. You killed Richard.
G'day, Dad.
Oh, God, it's hard.
Come in. Dad, I'd like you to meet Wendy Brown. Wendy, this is my father.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Bulpit.
G'day. Happy birthday. I haven't bought you a present because, fair go, I wouldn't know you from Adam.
No, it's not my birthday.
Oh, well, that saved me some money. Hang on. Is it your birthday?
No, Dad.
Oh, that's good, because I haven't got a present for you either.
Dad, it is no one's birthday.
Well, what are the candles for?
I don't know. For decoration, I suppose.
Well, why don't we use paper hats?
Dad, please. I'll just go and tell Mum we're here. Why don't you sit down, Wendy?
Oh, thank you.
Oh, no, not there. No.
Why not?
That's Dad's chair.
Oh.
I love my chair.
Good.
While you're out there, perhaps your girlie would like a drink. Would you like a drink, Kathy?
That's Wendy.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, what about a cordial? How about a nice cordial, eh?
Dad.
Oh, well, a sherry? I think Thelma's got some sherry out there somewhere.
No, thank you.
Oh, well, I don't know. Rum, do you drink rum?
Well, as a matter of fact, I'd rather like a beer.
A beer? Leave the money
Dad.
On the...
Yeah. Get back in the flesh.
Well.
Yeah.
Greg's told me a lot about you.
Why?
I don't know.
Oh. Do you happen to read Mandrake?
No.
Well, you won't mind if I do.
Greg was telling
kind of tarred.
Craig was telling me that you like Holdens.
Yeah, well, I'm Australian, aren't I?
Oh, yes. Is there anything you'd like to ask me?
Well, yeah.
What?
Do you like Holdens?
I love Holdens. I think they're the best cars on the road. In fact, I don't think you can go past a Holden.
Good girl. What have you got?
A Honda. I hate it. I'm going to shove it over the gap tomorrow.
Wendy.
Oh, thank God.
Wendy, this is Mum. Mum, Wendy.
Hello, Wendy.
I'm very pleased to meet you, Mrs. Bulbert. Oh.
So, you're the new girl who's been occupying so much of my little Craigie's time.
Please.
Now that we've officially met up, I'm sure we're going to see a lot more of each other.
Well, you must come over and visit us sometime.
Pardon, dear?
Oh, hasn't Craig told you? We're going to live together.
Oh, Ted, Craig's leaving home.
Does he want a hand with his luggage?
Oh, thank you. Well, you are Hannah Dale Simpson, is that correct?
That's right.
Stand on the line. Annadale Simpson, you are charged with armed robbery and are to be held on remand pending a hearing to answer this charge. Do you understand?
Yes, perfectly.
Do you have any money or valuables on you?
No, nothing.
Right. Well, you'll be fingerprinted, taken to the showers before you're shown to your cell.
Whatever you say.
It's almost time for the evening meal. You'll meet the other inmates there.
I'll give it a miss if you don't mind. I've already eaten.
All right. Mrs. Ward, will you take charge? All right, come on. You're allowed 5 minutes in the shower. Try and keep to it.
Who's the new one?
Simpson. Came in last night.
Huh?
Strange one. Haven't worked her out yet. Rather cold.
Really?
All right, everyone. That is Hannah Simpson. I'm sure you've all got a lot in common.
G'day. How you going?
Hello, love. What you in for, then?
Oh, she's up herself.
Be a sorter out.
Yeah.
Come on, you lot. Let's go.
I've been in and out most of me life. This is your first time, isn't it?
Yes.
I got put in for murder, but I never done it. What are you in for?
Look, I'd rather not talk about it.
All right, get on with your work.
Righto. See you later, then.
In case you hadn't guessed, that's the local sticky beak.
I had guessed.
Because you can't blame her for being interested. You're a very interesting lady. Clever how you got those men to do the job for you. Then I should imagine you could get anything you wanted, if you really tried. So can I. Patience is one of my virtues, Hannah.
Simpson, the police are here. They want to interview you. As you're on remand, you don't have to see them, but
then
I would suggest...
Won't.
Very well, I'll let them know. That's not a Christmas file, is it?
Well, yes. I was doing some homework.
No files are allowed out of reception.
Oh, I am sorry, Mrs. Powell. I'll put it right back.
Yeah, try your luck with the receptionist.
What was that remark?
Nothing at all.
I assume that whatever you said was directed at Officer Ferguson.
I don't want any trouble.
Then don't provoke it. Listen, Simpson, I'm the deputy governor here and I demand respect for my officers. Now, if you're convicted, you could be here for a very long time, so I wouldn't go and make any enemies.
All right, Hannah. I'm here now.
Do you mind? Look, I know what you want, but you picked on the wrong person. Just leave me alone.
Stop right there, Simpson.
No, I won't stop. I don't want any part of this place or the people in it, and that goes for you. But if I had to make a choice, I'd sooner be bashed by them than put up with your filthy paws all over me.
All right, Simpson. I get your message. Now you get mine. You don't have a choice, understand? In here, I can make or break you. And sooner or later, I intend to have you. Why aren't you in the rec room, Simpson?
Because I prefer my own company.
I can understand that. Sometimes I like to be alone. But then there are times when it's quite nice to have someone else around.
What are you doing and why did you close the door?
Because I think you and I should be friends, Hannah. We're going to be seeing a lot of each other.
Well, you can forget it. I'm not interested.
But you will be. We'll come to an understanding, you and I.
Don't you dare, unless you want the governor to hear about this.
That won't do you any good. Latham's already in the pound for trying to say she was raped by an officer. Think of the extra charges you'd collect. I don't think the judge would be very impressed at all. Pity I'm off duty right now. We'd start getting to know each other right away. Oh, but there'll be other times. After your trial tomorrow, there'll be plenty of other times. And believe me, Hannah, we're gonna be very good friends.
I've instructed counsel to apply for a postponement to prepare a defence. He'll claim a missing witness. I don't think we'll get it. Holsworthy's a crusty old sod at the best of times. Now, look, for Pete's sake, don't start claiming the stolen money was rightfully yours. I can understand how gratifying it may have been for you to see your father's company robbed, but the jury won't. You might just as well plead guilty.
Yeah, fine, okay. How's it going?
I think the judge has got a hangover. And the jury are demonstrating in the city square. God, I hate court duty.
Could be a long day. Any idea how long before they start?
No, they've got to get the jury in yet. That'll take about 20 minutes.
I'll take the first turn. You go out and get yourself a cup of coffee.
Oh, you sure?
Yes, you can take over after lunch.
Fair enough.
Miss Simpson, can you give me the name of anyone who might be able to verify where you were that afternoon? It's our only chance to gain a postponement.
No, I don't know anyone. I was on my own. Look out!
You are not to make a sudden move or sound.
Let it go!
Well, you didn't have to do that!
Shut up! You want to get out of here, don't you?
Come on, fella. Don't be bloody stupid. You'll never get out of here.
We'll get out. Just so long as no one tries to be a hero.
Oh. That way, get going. If anyone tries to stop us, this lady will be copping a bullet.
Thank you.
You stay here till we give you the word, Benny. Come on, Frank. Easy with that brush.
No one move.
I told you, you weren't going anywhere without me.
Benny, come and get this big bitch.
Try anything and I'll break her neck. Now tell him what we have to do, citizen. Tell him.
Forgive me, just get out of here, for God's sake, she'll kill me.
Yeah, we're okay. Our friend's a pretty small time, aren't they? Why aren't you in the dining room, Simpson? It's lunchtime. Did you hear me?
Yes, I heard.
What was that?
I said I heard you, Miss Ferguson.
That's better. I would have thought you'd want some lunch after all that exercise this morning. And we did have some exercise, didn't we? Although I don't think it was quite what you had in mind. Jogging, I think you had planned. Running away. Whose idea was it? Yours or theirs? Yours, I think. Those blokes wouldn't have had the nous to think of something like that. Picked the wrong mates, didn't you? Didn't you? You'd better get your powers of speech back. Because we're going to be seeing a lot of one another from now on. And I can't talk to myself all the time, can I?
What do you mean we'll be seeing a lot of one another?
Oh. There are some things that make you talk. I've been asked to keep a special eye on you. Particularly when we're alone. Just the two of us. I'll like that. I hope you do too. So, it'll help if we get along. Here. A peace offering.
Take it away. I don't want anything from you.
Come on, hurry up. Get in.
Oh. What's Simpson doing here?
Oh, I was just talking to her about lunch.
Too late for lunch now. Okay, there's your bed. Start putting your things away.
Is she coming in here?
Yeah. There's more room than any other dorm. What?
Oh, like, just never occurred to me, that's all.
Okay, Latham. As soon as you put your things away, you'll be in the workshop. Make it fast. Simpson, you'll be able to help Madam unpack. Settle in.
Welcome to our happy home.
Yeah. I hope it's happier than the last time we met anyway.
My friend isn't on laundry duty today.
Don't matter if she is. Her type don't pounce in front of an audience anyway.
Thanks a lot. You never know when they're going to crawl out from under their rock, do you?
Chrissy, can I have a word with Hannah on her own, please?
Yeah, sure. You wait right here, Chrissy. I really don't think I've got anything to say to you.
Well, I'd like to straighten out a couple of things.
What about?
I just think we had a little misunderstanding, that's all.
No way. I read you loud and clear.
Well, you read wrong. Hannah, I wasn't making a pass at you.
Well, that's a new approach. Why don't you pass it on to Ferguson? She could do a little subtlety.
Yeah, she could. Look, I'm gay, Ferguson's gay, but that's where any similarity ends.
You don't say.
I would never push myself on someone. I believe that a relationship should be a two-way thing with some love and caring.
Look, love, Jude's all right. She's never come on, Evie.
So why the extra interest?
Well, thought if I muscled in, she'd lay off, that's all.
She won't.
Well, it was worth a try. It still is. I've certainly never intended for you to take it the wrong way.
My mother's sick. She really needs the money. I can't get to it.
Is that letter for your mother?
No, it's for Duncan Campbell, the guy who was with me in the hold-up. I thought he might be able to get some money to her.
Well, there must be a way to get to him legit.
The warders are watching me. They follow up everything that goes out. If the police start snooping around Duncan, I've had it. Really, it's this way or nothing.
Does she really need that money?
Hospital bills like you wouldn't believe.
All right, I'll do it.
Thanks a million, Jude. I won't forget you for this.
Ah, Miss Simpson. Please sit down. I imagine you know why I'm here.
I've no idea where the money is, if that's what you mean.
Don't you understand that if you tell us, you might lessen your sentence?
I can't tell you something I don't know.
Then why did those gunmen take such a risk to try and free you?
Ever heard of loyalty?
Not with those thugs. You know something that they don't. The location of the loot.
Well, I'm sorry, you're mistaken.
Look, surely you want to get out of here as soon as possible?
Yeah, of course I do.
Then why don't you help yourself by helping us?
I don't see any point in going over this again and again. I don't know where the money is, and that's all I've got to say to you.
All right, Miss Simpson. Play it your way. But you better get used to this place, because you're going to be in here for a long, long time.
Well, what happened? What did Duncan say?
They're fixing it.
What did he say exactly?
Look, I've told him I'm not passing nothing on till I've got my dough.
You will get it.
I reckon Elizabeth's grown a bit since I last saw her. I suppose that Brenda must be looking after her, all right.
Did he say when?
Hey?
Did he say when they've planned it for?
No, no. He's going to tell me that when he comes in, with my money. I hated seeing her go. Why can't I have her in here with me?
Chrissy, do you realise how important this is to me?
Oh, you selfish bitch. I'm only talking about my little girl.
Yeah, all right. I can't blame you for that. My mother would have been the same about me.
Yeah?
Yeah. Broke her heart when I landed in here. She's not well and it didn't help. The ironic thing is I mainly did it for her.
Same as I did for Elizabeth. Mightn't have got into so much trouble otherwise. I just wanted what was best for her.
But he took what was ours anyway.
You try telling that to a judge. They couldn't give two bloody hoots why you did it. You know, I reckon you and me, we're not so different. Well, in some ways. What did B want?
Some stupid idea to get rid of Fergus and she wanted me to help her.
What did you say?
No, of course. What do you think I am? I'm getting mixed up with that stupid bitch when I'll be out of here in a few days.
Blimey, you didn't say that to B, did you?
No.
Thank God for that. The less women who know about this, the better. I'm not going to take the rap if it all goes wrong when you've been blabbing your mouth off about it.
I'm not!
You know, it's not a bad idea going along with B.
What?
Oh, listen to me, will you? Now, look. The women, they all know that Ferguson's been putting the hard word on you, don't they?
Yeah.
Well, if you don't go along with B, they might think that you and her are on together. Then you'll really be in for it. Well, either that or they're going to twig that you've got a plan of your own.
I don't care. That woman gives me the creeps.
What have you got to lose? Give it a go just for a little while. Like you've said, you've only got a couple of more days in here. If the women find out you're planning to go over the wall, Ferguson might find out about it.
Looks like I don't have much choice, doesn't it? I just hope things don't get too heavy in here in the next few days.
The way I see it, we set you up as if you're living in the lap of luxury.
What do you mean?
You have all this stuff in your room. More soap and knitting use, more chocolates, biscuits, coffee, fresh milk, that sort of thing.
How do we get that?
You don't. We do. But don't use any of it, because remember, it's all on loan. Then we start dropping comments to the screws that it's Joan who's supplying you with all the stuff she's pinched from the other women.
They won't buy it.
Of course not. If they catch you in bed with her as well, then she's a goner.
No way. I'm not going to be in that.
Now, calm down. It'll be all right. All you have to do is lead her on a bit, play hard to get. Now, you must have done that with fellas a million times. Then as soon as she's alone in the cell with you, we send Po-Face in to break it up.
And what if she doesn't get there?
She'll get there.
Seems to me like I'm taking all the risks.
Seems to me like you're forgetting that freak can have a go at you any time she likes.
Oh, you're a very pretty girl. Very pretty. And you haven't got anywhere to run, have you? So, if I want you, I'll have you. There's nothing you can do about it. But I have been known to be very good to my friends.
Oh, don't mind me. I only live here. It's hard to find privacy these days, isn't it?
How dare you talk to an officer like that?
No, I didn't mean nothing by it.
You shut up or I'll have you in the pound for insolence.
Please, Miss Ferguson, she didn't do anything.
Oh, really? I'm going to be watching you two very closely. Only one who can take care of you. Because I care about you. I can make your life in here very comfortable. If only you cooperate.
Miss Ferguson, I don't want to be comfortable. I just want to get out of here. So if you help me get out, I'll do anything you want.
You're in here to stay, Simpson. And the sooner you realize that, the easier it'll be for both of us. I can see I've been wasting my time with you. You're just as stupid and stubborn as the rest of them. Well, madam, you're just going to have to learn the hard way.
You're all bluff. You wouldn't touch me. You're too afraid of getting caught.
I have no intentions of touching you. There are plenty of other ways. And believe me, I know all.
Help! Help! She's dragging me! Help! Help me! Stop it! What's happening? What does the siren mean?
Like it if I know. They usually only sound it if there's a riot or a fire or if someone's gone over the wall.
You mean someone's escaped?
Like it if I know. But geez, I wish they'd turn it off.
G'day, love. Listen, what's all that noise about? Has someone tried to escape or something?
Chrissy's shot through with the laundry.
Lizzie!
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Faulkner. I can't help myself. You ought to do something.
No, I don't. You've done enough damage for one day.
Oh. Dirty double-crossing bitch, I'll kill her.
Hey, what's eating you? You can't blame her for trying.
That was supposed to be me.
What?
That escape was planned for me.
Well, how did Chrissy find out about it?
She knew all about it. She was acting as go-between and using Elizabeth for cover. Stupid bitch. They'll never let her get away with it.
Wouldn't worry about her if I were you.
It's not her I'm worried about. It's my mother.
Hey?
She'll lead those bastards straight to her. She thinks that's where the money's hidden.
And it's not.
No. They'll never believe her. They'll kick her to death before they believe her. Bloody Chrissy. I know Chrissy's going to take them to Mum's place. I just know she will.
Well, if she's got any sense, she'll just tell them where the money is. That'll keep her out of trouble for a while.
Yeah, that's the problem. She doesn't know. I collected the money before the police arrested me.
Jesus. You're never going to believe that. Lizzie, you better call the cops in, love. That's your only chance.
Come on, quiet
and down. There's no talking in solitary unless you want to stay here longer.
Mrs. Powell, I've got to see the police urgently.
Look, if it's about Officer Ferguson, you see the guy...
Just shut up, Smith, will you? When are you going to learn to mind your own business?
Okay, what's the problem?
I know where Chrissy Latham's... Chrissy thinks the money from the payroll is at her place and the guys that got her out of here will do anything to get their hands on it.
Who are they?
I don't know. You get to her place and you'll find them.
What do you mean you don't know?
Look, all I know is that it was arranged by someone who wanted a cut of the payroll robbery. It was done through intermediaries.
And you say the money's not there?
Yes.
Well, where is it then?
Look, we're talking about a favour for a favour. You want Chrissy and the guys that got her out of here back, and I want my mother protected. The other thing has nothing to do with the deal.
And how do I know you're not sending me off on a wild goose chase while Latham and her boyfriend go off in the opposite direction?
You don't, but I'm not.
All right, Simpson. We'll play it your way. But if you're mucking me about... What's your mother's address?
17 Ignatius Street, Kensington.
I'll give you another deal to think about while you're in here, Hannah. The money. In exchange for an early release from here. Oh, I can swing it for you. Think about it. And think about the alternative.
You're right about that bastard, you know. So long as I've got that money, my mother's in trouble. I'm going to fix it in the morning. It's all so clear, it's just come to me.
That's what I've been trying to tell you, Anna. If we give him his money back, it's not going to hassle anyone no more, is he? Oh, thanks, Anna. Thanks, I feel much better.
And I'm going to fix Mr. Duncan Campbell at the same time.
Eh?
He's not going to get 1 cent of my father's money.
No, Anna, you can't do a deal with him without the money. What are you talking about?
It's going back to the estate.
No. No, it can't. What about Elizabeth? What about your mother?
Once he realises he can't get his hands on it, it's the end of the whole thing. He'll leave us all alone.
Like bloody hell he will.
He's not getting anything.
You bloody stupid bitch. If he touches one hair on Elizabeth's head, I'll kill you. For God's sake, will you just listen to me for a minute?
You're amazing, Chrissy. You just don't understand, do you?
He's got my kid. That's all I'm interested in. Now, if you go and tell the cops about the money, he's going to kill her.
Look, I'll explain it to you once again. Duncan is a businessman. He's only interested in the money. Now, if the police beat him to it, he'll fade into the background. There's no profit in revenge. Now, is that clear?
But you don't know that for sure, you silly bitch.
What do you think you two are doing? Come on, get moving.
Mrs. Powell, may I see you a minute, please?
What about?
I'm ready to talk to the police about...
No!
I'm ready to talk to the police about the robbery I was involved in. Will you tell them I'd like to see them, please?
Yes, I can do that. Now, come on, hurry.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
All right, Anna, where is it? Where's my bra?
What are you talking about?
Don't you play silly buggers with me, you silly bitch. Just hand it over.
What would I want with your bra? I mean, it's bad enough sleeping in the same cell with you, let alone wearing your clothes.
The bleeding money was in there as if you didn't know. You saw me put it in there.
You mean you've left it in there all this time?
Yeah, till you got your little mitts on it, yeah.
I didn't touch your money. I didn't think you'd be stupid enough to leave it in there, though.
Well, I've been through 2 searches, haven't I?
Well, why pick on me?
Because you're the only one who knew I put it there.
You're the Peter thief, remember, not me.
All that talk about morals and money. You, it's just a load of bull. I want my money, Anna.
Let go of me. I don't know what it's about to bring.
My money, Anna.
I don't know what it's about to bring.
Bloody hell, you.
Cut it out, Chrissy. Get off.
Back off. Back off, Latham. Right, now, who started this? Simpson?
Oh, come on, isn't it obvious?
Get back to work, Smith. Now, maybe you'll think twice before you start another fight, Simpson.
How do you work that out? It's obvious she's getting the worst of it.
Are you still here, Smith? Get back to work! Right. So much for you two lovebirds. Now, next time you try to break up your affair, don't be so messy about it. Now, clean this mess up, Simpson. Latham, back to work.
How are you? You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. No thanks to Chrissy, though. So what was it all about? I suppose you'll have to find out sooner or later. I had to pay Chrissy before she'd help me with the escape.
Oh, sounds like Chrissy all heart.
Anyway, Duncan paid her off, and now she claims that I stole it.
Well, it must have been a fair bit the way she was carrying on.
2,000.
Bloody hell.
Struth, why don't you contact me next time you need some help with an escape?
I didn't take it, Bea, honestly. I've only stolen once in my life. That's why I'm here.
Fair enough.
Well, how would she smuggle 2 grand in here in the first place?
That's not the point. If she's right, and she didn't steal it, and she did have it, then there's someone walking around here with an awful lot of dough. Now, I wonder who that could be.
Rightio, what gives?
Hell, Bea, you should see Chrissy. It looks as though somebody's been using her for a footy.
Ah, so she did get into a brawl.
Yeah, well, she couldn't say very much because Mrs. Morris was there all the time. But something's up.
Well, it could have been anyone. Chrissy didn't exactly make inmate of the month.
Yeah, well, she said that she'd had a freak accident.
What? Don't tell me she'd be stupid enough to take on Ferguson.
She mightn't have had any say in it.
But Ferguson wouldn't leave her looking like that. The department would have her out in her ear.
In that case, I hope it is her. Maybe she won't get away with it.
Yeah, and better it happened to Chrissy than any one of us.
Well, fair enough. But that doesn't alter the fact we've got a bad screw on our hands. And just think, next time it'll be one of you.
And what's amusing you, Simpson?
Nothing, Miss Ferguson.
Let's see if you can get a laugh out of cleaning the toilets.
But I didn't do anything wrong.
Oh, G3, Mr. Faulkner's waiting for you at the security gate. You? Come with me.
Where to?
I just told you, the toilet block.
Can't I clean out somewhere else?
Well, you're frightened of getting your nice little hands grubby. Don't worry, you'll be safe. But life could have been a lot easier for you if you'd been a bit smarter at the start. Now move.
Hiya, scrubber.
God, Maxine, almost had a fit.
Why did you think it was? The bear.
I don't know, it's got a fright, that's all. Who's the bear?
Ferguson, who else?
We call her the freak.
Yeah, I know. Well, I call her anything I can get me tongue to. The bear. The freak. Dickhead.
God, you're a trick, Maxine. You're a bright spot around here, you really are.
Yeah, well, not for long, sweetheart, because this little one's about to walk right out the door.
You lucky bugger, how come?
I'm having it off with Davo.
God, doesn't anything worry you?
Nah. Secret to my success. Never let the bastards get you down.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Yeah. Anyway, see you, love.
Bye.
You've been having a bit of trouble with Fergo lately, haven't you?
Well, why do you think I'm cleaning the toilets?
Well, I do have one other secret to my success.
Yeah?
And it's all to do with keeping Fergo under control. I don't think she'd mind if I shared it with you.
Right, Simpson, on your feet. I'm putting you on a charge.
What for? What to do this time?
Well, I've just inspected the shower block that you're supposed to have scrubbed.
Yeah, I did.
It looks like a badly kept brothel.
Then you should feel right at home, shouldn't you?
Oh, little Miss Purity's finally found some guts. Or are you just feeling lucky?
Not lucky. Just prepared. Maxine gave me a little going-away present about when she knew you in Queensland.
Oh, so you're the one. Now, I let Daniels get away with that for a while because she was only in here for a short time. But you, you're a long-termer. Don't imagine that I'm going to put up with that hanging over my head for long, do you? Now, Latham tried to stand up to me, and she's a lot tougher than you are.
I wouldn't do anything like that to me if I was you, because you don't know who I've told.
Right. Now, just exactly what did she tell you?
How you forced yourself on someone? Gave her privileges, presents. Only your protection wasn't very effective, was it? The other women got to know and they bashed her up, didn't they? They got a bit carried away and they killed her.
They
murdered her.
Yeah, and you went on a little bashing spree of your own, didn't you? Until the authorities found out and forced you to resign. I'm sure there's a lot of people that would like to know about that now.
Trust Daniels to make something dirty of it. She didn't understand. Nobody did.
Mrs. Powell.
Simpson's asked to see you as well. I thought you might be interested in what she has to say.
I assume you are both here on behalf of all the women.
That's about the size of it. They asked me and Hannah to speak for all of them.
Then perhaps you will start by explaining to me why you have taken such drastic action against Officer Ferguson.
We didn't have any choice, Mrs. Davidson.
You could have spoken to me first.
Hannah did. When she told you what was going on, you were too busy protecting your staff.
That is untrue and uncalled for, Smith. I even went as far as to contact the Queensland authorities. There is not one shred of evidence to support Simpson's allegations.
No evidence?
Evidence? Isn't Chrissy's bashing evidence enough? And what about all
Miss
the other...
Miss Ferguson was defending herself against Latham's attack. Nothing more. If there had been any evidence to the contrary, I would have taken immediate action against the officer involved.
We think there's evidence enough, that's why we're taking action. Can't you see that?
It doesn't matter whether I see your point or not. I am obliged to support my officers until such time as they prove they are not worthy of my support. Now, will you please stop this stupidity and acknowledge Miss Ferguson's authority?
Otherwise, you'll make us, right?
I have no other option, and you know it.
All right, I'll tell the others. But if I were you, I wouldn't hold my breath waiting. And your name is Hannah Dale Simpson, is that correct?
Yes.
And you are charged as follows, that you did rob the Ludlow Manufacturing Company of $102,700 while armed with a firearm, breach of prison, conspiracy to escape from lawful imprisonment, and accessory to wounding with intent to murder.
Yes, well, we've heard it all before, haven't we?
And remanded in custody awaiting sentence. Is that correct?
It is.
You've changed, Simpson. You used to be quite different.
If I have, you're probably responsible for it.
Get to the showers, both of you. Not at work, Simpson?
I got permission from Mrs. Powell to organise a few of my things.
Well, you seem to be working very hard for Mrs. Powell's approval.
I asked. She let me do it. It's not against regulations, you know.
Pity, you know. Things could have been quite different for you in here.
You mean for you, don't you?
No. Because when you're a prisoner in here, Simpson, you can't control what happens to you, but I can. And I intend to do so. Got a little surprise in store for you, Simpson. You're being transferred to Barnhurst, Simpson.
Really?
Yes, you're to pack your things after the evening meal and be ready to leave straight away.
I think she'll be glad to see the back of me. What do you think, Bea?